This week's video is a requested topic, and I've actually been putting it off because I was a little bit intimidated by the topic, but it is a request, so I do want to do it. I just don't know if I'm even the best person for this topic, but I'm going to share with you what I do know. And so the topic that was requested in this video is relationships. So if you want to stick around, I'm going to share with you what I know about relationships. So this video topic, relationships, is a big one, and I'm not a relationship expert, but I guess I've had a few relationships, and that's everything you do in life. You learn things, and I guess I have some things I can share, what I've learned about being in relationships. I think the most important thing is to find someone who's kind to you, and then you need to also be very kind to that person. It needs to be someone who's, you know, a really good friend, but you need to be ready to be in a relationship first and foremost. You know, if you've just gotten out of a relationship and maybe you're still dealing with some kind of emotional trauma or damage from that, or maybe you just barely moved into a new city or a new situation, you know, a new job or something, and you're settling in where there's a lot of new things going on in your life, then, you know, sometimes it's easier to focus on those things and not look for a relationship. Some of the worst relationships I've ever seen, like especially the ones that ended really badly, because I've watched a lot of friends have relationships too, are the ones where people who got into the relationships were like really desperate to find another person. So I think it's really important before you go look to find a person to be in a relationship that you evaluate if you are looking for a person to be in a relationship because you feel like there's something missing in your life or you need to complete something in yourself. Another person isn't going to fill that void. That's a void you have to fill on your own before you drag another person into it. There's some healing that needs to be done. And if you kind of have this void, you know, that you haven't figured out yourself, just dragging someone else into that isn't always going to be helpful. Not to say that it can't work out, but it just, people, you know, aren't, you know, you have to be happy with yourself, and another person and being in your life isn't going to make you happy. You can't put your happiness on another person, because that can put you in a really desperate situation. If you base all your happiness on another person and you aren't happy on your own as an individual with yourself, with who you are, if that person turns out to be a lousy person, because some people will act really one way when they start getting in a relationship, and then once they feel comfortable, they relax and they're someone completely different, intentionally even, some people. And if you've put all your happiness in this person and they turn out to be a really horrible, abusive, or manipulative, or just not a good person, you're going to be much more reluctant to leave a bad situation. So it's really important that you just kind of have that ability to stand and know who you are as a person individually before you try to get into a relationship with someone else. Because this is true, you know, not just for romantic relationships, but for any kind of relationship or any close relationship, you pick up habits from the people who are around you all the time. So if you're around people who are very negative and pessimistic and just doing bad things or are bad people or take advantage of other people, you pick up those people's habits. Maybe not some of their worst habits, but you pick up habits from, you know, the closest people to you. And if the closest people to you are really not that great people, you're going to pick up bad habits. But if you surround yourself with really amazing, awesome people that you feel good about yourself when you're around, and you do good things and they do good things, and you just influence each other to be good, your life is just going to be better because there's just going to be more good things in your life because there's more, you know, your circle around you. The negativity just kind of draws in more trouble and more drama. So people that kind of cling to that and really love drama and really love trouble and like to complain a lot and whine, I don't have a lot of that in my life. Or people that that's just where they, if they can't get out of it. I know your friends sometimes might have a hard day and they need to complain, like they might need to complain about something because it's bothering them, and talking can be helpful. And then you can listen to your friend and help them feel better. But that's different than the people who are perpetually in this negative drama vacuum cycle where they are always blaming their troubles on other people. So that's different. So like that's kind of a big thing for me with caution with relationships, is being very mindful of the types of people that you have relationships with. And then when you find good, wonderful people, there are things that you need to do to keep those people around. You need to be considerate of the feelings of your friends and your loved ones and the people in your life. You have to realize that they don't always have the same perspectives that you do on certain issues. Sometimes even issues that you may feel very strongly about, and that can make relationships difficult. And you have to make choices like, do I love this person enough to say, okay, well, I'm going to respect their decision, even if I think it's stupid, because that's their right? Or is this something that's like a big moral thing where it's like, I can't have someone who thinks this is okay in my life? And you have to like know what those lines are and be firmly drawing those lines within yourself. So it kind of comes back on yourself, really. For your relationships with other people, you have to be the police of those relationships, and you have to moderate those relationships and what you allow and what you tolerate. And also, you have to give out love to the people that you care about, your loved ones, your family, your friends. You have to make sure you are actively showing, you know, the people that you care about them. Because if you don't show them you care about them, they won't know. And just telling them you love them may or may not be good enough for some people. So you have to kind of consider your audience, I guess, too. Some people, you know, it's you just have to show someone. And even just like doing nice things for people. Like, you know, if you're out shopping with your friend and you see that she really likes a ring or some jewelry or something, you can maybe like remember or write it down if you don't remember. And then that way you could know next time, like, if you buy birthday presents for people, that's maybe like a good way to do it. Or, I don't know, if you don't go out a lot, like with a boyfriend or a husband or whatever, you can cook them something as a surprise and like bring it upstairs and like, here, I brought you a muffin, or I brought you some eggs, or, you know, and that's like a nice thing you can do for someone. And just being considerate of people's feelings. Even if you don't understand their feelings or know what their feelings are, just realizing that other people have feelings that may be different from your own and respecting those. And this is coming back, you know, here, like, you have to know to do these things, because if you don't, people are going to kind of want to push you away because people want to feel respected. It's, you want to feel respected too, so it makes sense. And you also have to make sure that the people you allow into your life, you expect to be respected by people in your life. Don't let people into your life and allow them to talk ugly to you and talk trash to you and be rude to you and take advantage of you. Those kinds of people don't need to be in your life. So you all need to understand and see those kinds of things and realize when they're happening, so that once you realize someone is bad for you, you know, like, to cut them out. And it sucks when someone who you thought was good for you turns out to be bad for you, and you're like, oh, this is my friend. But you, if you evaluate, you know, logical way that your friend is bringing little taunts of shitty trouble to your life, then it's like, bye, you're not really my friend if you're causing a lot of trouble in my life. So, I mean, that's my advice on relationships. I'm not sure if it's actually the way or the topic, the way it was requested, but that's my spin on it, because I think a lot of it has to start with you, and you have to be ready here for the relationships. You have to be ready for them. And it's a lot of work to get yourself ready to be in a relationship, especially a very serious one. But I think it's worth it. And you guys have a great week. And this video is really long and rambly. It's like the longest video I'm ever posting. So I'm going to let you guys go. But if you want to tell me anything, advice you have in the comments below, I'll be reading them. And maybe we'll read some out in a future video. I will talk to you next week. Bye, guys.